Let's talk about getting Python applications into production as quickly as humanly possible. Getting your code into production is probably the most important thing that a developer can do. All that effort, all that time, all that mental energy that you've put into building your code, no one really gets to see it unless it's in production. So getting code into production really is one of the most important things that you'll do in your working day. But what do we want the path to production to be like? Well, people want to have the best code and the best tools. They want to have safety and security and peace of mind. They want productivity and speed. What happens when we get that path to production right? Well, again, research shows you see an increase in the path to production efficiency of about 82 percentage points. We have a nearly a 40% increase in developer productivity, so that's like getting 2 days back a week. That's great. So where do these numbers come from? Well, this research was done by the cloud-foundry organization. So what is cloud-foundry? Well, it's a developer-friendly platform that takes your code and it will run it in any cloud. So if you've got AWS or GCP or Azure, or you can even run it on Kubernetes. So it's a very flexible system, and the application service has been around for a long time. So it's very strong, it's very fast, it's very secure, and it's perfect for Python applications. Why is it so popular? Well, you just CF push your application and that's it. Your app can go live straight away. It has a really handy command line tool called CF, and from there you can push and start and scale or stop applications in seconds. You can just self-serve. Now, included in Cloud Foundry is a Python Buildpack. That means that it's really easy to take your code, turn it into a container and deploy it into dev or production or whichever spaces you want to deploy it into really, really quickly, like seconds. So you should expect big increases in developer productivity. If you're wondering where you can get Cloud Foundry, it's implemented by several different vendors, so there's a lot of choice. VMware has one in the Tanzu brand, Tanzu application service, but you can also get Cloud Foundry from SAP, from SUSE, IBM, Atos, and Swisscom. But if you don't have access to any of those in your organization, then don't despair because you can run Cloud Foundry on top of Kubernetes. And then you can get the same great CF push experience locally just using your very own Cloud Foundry installation. And if you want help on how to install Cloud Foundry on Kubernetes, then we have a great guide for you. Go and check it out using the URL at the bottom of the screen there. Let's now go push a Python application to Cloud Foundry. Here I am at my desktop and I'm ready to push my first Python application to Cloud Foundry. But before I do that, let me show you where to find the CF command line tool that you need. So if you go to docs.cloudfoundry.org, and then you scroll down here in the documentation, you'll see Cloud Foundry CLI and how to install it. I've already gone ahead and done that. I've got the CF command line tool installed already. Here's the help. So this is how I interact with my Cloud Foundry installation, which in this case is sat out on the web in the cloud somewhere. But you could also run it locally. So we have a look at where I'm currently targeting. If I do CF target, you can see that I have a username, an API endpoint, but I'm also have an org and a space. That's just how Cloud Foundry divides up all the different compute power. I also have my Python application. I'm in the folder where that application lives. Let's take a look. It's not a fancy app, I just wanted to show you quickly how to push things into Cloud Foundry. So let's do that now. So I'm going to CF push. I'm going to call my application the Python demo. I'm going to tell Cloud Foundry to use the Python build pack. And in this case, I'm going to choose a random route. That's just so that my route doesn't clash with someone else's. So what's happening now is all the code is being pushed to Cloud Foundry, and Cloud Foundry is using the Python build pack to turn that code into a container. And that container will contain the operating system and everything that's required to run the Python interpreter and my application code. Okay, the application has started, so it's running in the cloud in my production space. All I need to do to talk to it is to use the correct URL. So let's give that a try. And there we are, hello world. Cloud Foundry took care of everything. It sorted out the networking and the DNS. It even does load balancing. I can scale this application up or down. It really is very, very easy.